Breaking news that could affect your shopping this weekend. A massive response as fire rips through a tri-state flea market. You can see smoke coming up through the roof as firefighters work to put out the flames. This is the Caesar Creek Flea Market next to I-71, and at one point flames. And look at that black smoke barreling out of the building. Viewers were emailing and calling us saying they could see it from miles away. NewsWise Karen Johnson live at the scene in Wilmington. She has the latest. Karen?
Well, Jack, right now, just a few crews are still on the scene. I'm told they are putting out hot spots. Now, if you are familiar with the Caesar Creek Flea Market, the fire happened on the other end, furthest away from I-71. The area that was damaged was the main aisle where the food court is, and aisle 5, which is right next door.
We live in Waynesville. We came from Waynesville, and we could see the smoke all the way up here. It was a lot of black smoke.
And I've had several people tell me they could see the smoke all the way from the Jeremiah Morrow Bridge in Warren County. This is what it looked like around 2 o'clock this afternoon. An all call went out, meaning every fire department in Clinton County was called to the scene, plus backup from Warren County. The Chester Township Fire Chief says it took about 150 firefighters to get this fire under control. They did run into issues, he tells me, with lack of water and manpower. The market was not open today, which is good news. However, some vendors were inside at the time. They all got out safely. And just a short time ago, the president of the company that owns the flea market gave the vendors an update.
We will not be opening tomorrow, obviously. We will be securing the building. We have the adjusters on the way. They're going to be boarding up all the openings. The fire department has said that no one can go on the property or in the building for at least a couple of hours.
And now I'm being told no one will be allowed on the property at all the rest of the day. And some vendors are not insured, so they did lose quite a bit, as you can imagine. One firefighter, I'm told, was treated for smoke inhalation, but is expected to be okay. Reporting live in Wilmington, Karen Johnson, News 5.